Hello everyone, and welcome back to another round of TWR Reviews. Today I'll be taking a look at the Thomas and the Magic Railroad 100-piece movie set. This item was sold exclusively at Zany Brainy stores in the year 2000, to coincide with the release of Thomas and the Magic Railroad, the movie this set is based off of. The vehicles this set came were Thomas, Lady, Diesel 10, Splatter, Dodge, Birdie, and Harold. This set also comes with a nice assortment of figurines, such as the articulated Sir Topham and Lady hat, a conductor, two workmen, and four exclusive Thomas and the Magic Railroad figures. These figures are Mr. Conductor, Patch, Mutt, and Lily, who all are very well detailed, and they even recycle the same shapes as some of the workmen, except for Mutt, who has his own special design. This set also comes with a plethora of accessories, which consist of a variety of oak and pine trees, buildings, signs, and signals. Without the accessories, this set would look quite bare, as seen in this example. It just goes to show how much care was put into these products and how stunning the attention the detail was. It also comes with several destinations such as the windmill, the Archstone Bridge, the single stone tunnel, and two special engine sheds, all of which can be incorporated into the play to reenact scenes from this movie. This set's layout was also recycled from the regular 100-piece set, which was discontinued the previous year. The only major difference being the two sidings near the sheds, now in rail to surface ramps, as opposed to buffers, likely something to do with the designers only wanting to have one siding end in buffers, so kids know that that is supposed to represent the magic buffer specifically. This set also includes an exclusive storage bin with brightly illustrated cartoon promos of Thomas and the movie's newcomers. It can store the whole set inside with room to spare. As a lid, there is a cushion, which can also be used to sit on, which is some very creative thinking and very convenient for the user. However, with all of these clever design choices, I think that there are a few which might have been overlooked. The inclusion of the workmen and Sir Topham Hatt and Lady Hatt seem a little odd, as Sir Topham Hatt and Lady Hatt weren't even seen in the movie, with the exception of portrait cameos and a few mentions. And there were no workmen to be seen throughout the movie. I think that instead of four exclusive figurines, why not eight? The workmen could have been easily replaced with more human characters from the movie, such as Brunette Stone, Stacy Jones, Billy Two Feathers, and Junior. Heck, why not go the extra mile and replace the hats with Lily's mother and P.T. Boomer? But then again, I might be getting a little ahead of myself. The layout also could have easily incorporated some elements from the Muffle Mountain set, such as the Viaduct, the Golden Bumpy Track, Shining Time Station, or maybe even Muffle Mountain itself. But then again, I might be getting a little ahead of myself. One last thing this set lacks is rolling stock. There doesn't appear to be much for Thomas and his friends to do when they aren't solving mysteries. Why not include Thomas's faithful coaches Annie and Clarabelle, as they were seen in the film? While we're at it, let's throw in a coal car, such as Fred Pelhay, as a coal car was a major plot device in the movie. We could even include Percy to balance out the hero-villain dynamic engine-wise. However, with what we've been given, what do I think of the set itself as a whole? It definitely is a fun-filled set, with plenty of accessories, characters, and destinations. It could have used some alterations to make it stand out from its predecessor, the 100-piece set, but is overall a great and creative set. This set is extremely hard to find, as it was only available for 1 year, and was an exclusive to one toy store. However, if you manage to get lucky like me and find it complete for a reasonable price, I would highly recommend it. This is Andy Harrelson, and thank you for watching my TWR review of the Thomas and the Magic Railroad 100-piece movie set. And stay tuned for more reviews to come.
I'm not sure.